I grew up in the golden age of Lubavitch. So from a very young age, there were so many opportunities to see the Rebbe, to interface with the Rebbe. And the Rebbe was there to lift us up, to give us perspective, solace when necessary, encouragement, to share the joys. A world with the Rebbe in it was a world that had an anchor.
I was a reporter at the New York Times from 1975 to 1993. And in those years, I had many opportunities to write about the growth of the Lubavitch movement and to write about Rabbi Schneerson in particular. I think most celebrities are people that you may admire, but you don't get a sense that they care that much about you. And the Rebbe was different. He really cared about every person.
I have not seen you a long time, all since I arrived.
It could be a little bit better.
Then it would be a lot better.
Amen.
The natural color shall use the happy fire I do to have her and the kid, which is simple to live well.
And
you'll
better.
Yeah, Kibble Tankin, the Sorot Award being a measure of the team.
Oi, to them.
The Havada Shali, the Higamkin, he started wood. Being a new operative, so call her pain in the life.
He wanted you to be a better person. He wanted you to be a better Jew. He wanted you to practice the rituals and the commandments of Judaism. Those things would make you a better person and make the world better.
I am a writer, primarily on Jewish themes, and I've recently completed a 5-year project on the Rebbe. The Rebbe had a greater capacity than anyone I've ever come across to appreciate that a human being is created in the divine image. He saw that spark of divinity in every Jew, that every Jew therefore was connected, even if that person felt distant now.
You're not changing anything. You're only returning to your real essence and doing so on your own volition, and then it will come to you automatically to progress in all things of Yiddishkeit.
The Rebbe was still seeing that divine spark within them. He saw not only who they were now, he saw also what they could become and how precious they were.
When one walked into the Rebbe's study, you saw nothing but the Rebbe. It was not an ostentatious office. It's not like going into the president or governor's offices or even deans of law schools. The Rebbe's office was not that at all. It was him. He can't enforce anything he wants. All he can do is advise and suggest. And that distinguishes him from every other leader I've met. They have the power of the purse. They have the power of the sword. They have the power of the media. They have the power of law. Rebbe has no power, only the authority that he himself brings through his personality and his leadership.
Yes. What happened to the book?
Well, I'm doing some things in that direction, which I will, I'll inform you as it goes along.
It takes you too long yet.
You're right.
You have much more things to do after you finish that.
Okay.
Yes. This was a wonderful year, Baruch Hashem, but this was our greatest accomplishment of 1988. To be elected a senator was nice, but this was the best.
But don't be satisfied. It's not even with you.
Okay, we both heard.
Heitz ochon arum kuchen, wird man erschrocken, was tut sich das in der Welt? Und was mit der Leder und mit Schoner und Schoner is achscher dore bit mir. Am gitzach hakuke nieder chile katevis geber und nieder seder wird al starker und nied gedusche verruchni is. Is meschel vishelet nor lichayere leheper. Ados is a jinnye von a jahr, was dorten gewaltigen chayis reus.
The Rebbe's mission was to call the world's bluff and reach right in and invert its reality and expose the core, expose the goodness. And he did that on every level, to the world entire, to each person he touched.
We should know that we are living in an entire world. That is a world that is a God. A not stam a sode, a se tvuo, nor that is a God from a se peris. That is a zamin world wo der Rebbeister sagt, dass er apart ist, wo das apart ist allein.
Just imagine that you are an eagle and you were raised as a duck. So you think that you are a duck and you live like a duck and sometimes raises you and you find out that it's an eagle. Then you spread your wings and go. You soar up to heaven. You are now above all these things. So that is what called the touch the Rebbe had, and it was a spark, went there and ignited them. And the person is not only didn't return to what he was, he changed completely from one place to another.
Ich schaß mi verbinzer, mit a Sach, wo sie gefind sich eben, mit a Sach, wo sie le meile min a Zman und min a Mocke, ist afal pi, wo sie gefind sich in Zman und in Mocke, gibt ihm der Eberste die Möglichkeit, als ich ihn sehe, wird er durchführen den Ebersten Schlichus. Die Schaß ist verbunden eben, oder dämmelt fällt mir nicht unten.
The influence of the Jewish people to the big task. But nevertheless, every Jew has the power to do so, because he is going with the help of the blessing of God Almighty himself.
I promise I'll do my best.
Yeah, God Almighty
will help you. Lubavitcher Jews around the world today began 7 days of mourning for their beloved leader, Rabbi Schneerson.
Rabbi Schneerson was a great leader of the Lubavitcher people. He was a great religious leader of the Jewish people. He was also a great religious leader of all people all throughout the world.
I was aware that he was not well, but his death, of course, was devastating to everybody in the world. Who could ever succeed this Rebbe? I mean, he was such a giant.
The Rebbe rewrote the book on what it meant to be a Hasidic leader. The Rebbe sort of broke down that wall and said, I have something to give and to contribute and to teach to all Jews. He was one of a kind, so with him gone, how could the movement survive?
The Rebbe's passing was a loss on a personal level, but beyond that, it seemed to be the eclipse of a light the world needed so badly. That was the true loss. But as it turned out, that was never lost. It lives on, and the Rebbe's teaching in the Rebbe's direction that fuel our work today.
When you are stranded in the wilderness, you really don't know anything. So you have a light, and the light guides you. And then somehow the light is extinguished in the middle of the night in some moment. How do you feel that? And you have, on the other hand, you don't have any permission to stop. See? And the Rebbe gave an order, marching orders,
So you have to go on marching.
For the Rebbe, there was nothing more precious than every single human being, and there was nothing more precious than every single mitzvah. The marching orders were, bring these two preciousnesses together. One of the ways in which this book itself profoundly influenced me was the Rebbe's insistence on the importance of every mitzvah, which brings me now, when I do a mitzvah, to have a much greater increased sense of its power to affect me.
Every one of us is putting tefillin, you in and you out are true to you. Someone else, he must begin putting tefillin. That alone is a very worthwhile endeavor. For adding a Jew to put tefillin. You're welcome.
You know, the greatest immortality somebody can ever have is to leave a legacy and to see one's work continue after one sheds the mortal coil. And the Rebbe did a phenomenal job in preparing his movement, the Jewish world, and the entire world.
To think that he had built this movement from the time he became Rebbe in the 1950 or 1951, and it had this phenomenal growth, that growth would have continued sort of exponentially after his passing is kind of hard to imagine, hard to believe. It just shows that, you know, the power of the message that he had and that he has been able to, in some ways, transcend life.
The Rebbe saw each person as a stakeholder in this awesome project. We have the responsibility and the privilege of moving it forward. By adding one new mitzvah, everyone can become a stakeholder in the Rebbe's project as it continues to move forward and to grow.
Al kol ha'ilam kuli machriye likav schuz. Bringt us the geyula bepeil mamash nitech simcha v'tuv levo.